Sierra Leone, land that I love, a beautiful country. Welcome back to my channel. I trust that you're all doing well, you're safe, you're healthy, you're bubbling, you're happy. Continue to be happy and keep smiling. Today we are doing cassava leaves. This is the cassava leaves. You can get it from any African store. It is processed already. This is locust beans. It's called dawa dawa in Twi. I don't know what it's called in Nigeria, but we use it in Sierra Leone to make kenda. And this is palm oil. This is about 4 tablespoons. And it's also from Sierra Leone. I got this palm oil from Sierra Leone. This is salt, about 1 tablespoon. This is peanut butter. I'll be using about 4 tablespoons to do cassava leaves. And this is ogiri. It's fermented sesame seeds. This is fish, kini fish. It's from Sierra Leone as well. This is pork, salted pork. It has been out for about 10 days. And it has a lot of pork, so salt, sorry, so I have to wash it, cut it out and wash it. I will not be using all of that pork. I have my peppers, chili peppers, white, green and red for flavor, habanero for spice, and onions. So I'll blend the onions, cassava leaves, peppers, locust beans, and ogiri together with little water. You should watch the water. And the cassava leaves is processed, as I said, but it's not smooth as I like it, so I always blend it. And I will wash the pork. I said it's salty, so I will cut it out, use some of it and wash it. Try to remove most of the salt from it. So the cassava leaves is really nice as I'm looking at it, so I'm going to blend it. Now we have all the blended ingredients together in the pot, and it's always advisable to leave your pot open. And I want you to watch the color. See, it's bright green. By the time we boil it for about 35, 40 minutes or even 60 minutes, it will be dark green. And the reason why we leave the pot open is to get rid of the hydrogen cyanide. It's a poison that is on the leaves and the cassava tuber. That's why it's advisable not to eat them raw. And hydrogen cyanide evaporates just a little over room temperature. So when it's boiling, it will evaporate and it will leave the cassava leaf yummy. So there is no harm in eating cassava leaves. And also, I didn't use all of the locust beans in the packet I showed, just that I only used a handful of it. So this will be boiling and the house will be full of the aroma from the locust beans and the ogiri. And even the salted pork, they all have their own unique scent that gives the cassava leaves some good flavor. I'll be adding okra to eat this, about 5 okra. I'm going to chop it out. See how messy the stovetop is? Cassava leaves is very messy when cooking it. I'm giving the pot a good stir. I'm just showing you around all the mess it has caused. So I'm reducing the heat. The heat, when reduced, stop all the messiness. That's what I observe. I'm going to put the peanut now. Peanut gives it a nice taste, and for me it helps with the digestion of the cassava leaves. That's what I observed as well. So here we have it. Our peanut goes. I'm adding salt. I tasted behind the camera, it was not there was not enough salt, so I'm adding all of this. Now there goes in a salt, and I will stir it again and taste. And then I will try to keep everything nice and clean. The tasting is going on. I think I need to add all the salt. So there goes our salt. Boiling. It's on low heat now, and I'm just giving it a good stir so that all the salt will get incorporated. And here goes our palm oil. Guys, if you have a different method of cooking it, please share. The palm oil is very nice, so I decided to put it at this time. If the palm oil is not nice, you can start by boiling the palm oil when you start all the boiling process. But if you have a good, nice palm oil like this, you can put it at this time. And I'm just trying to clean all the messiness around the pot to get everything incorporated. Give it another stir. Yeah, it's coming together nicely, beautifully. It's coming together. See how red and fresh the palm oil is. He wants you to observe the color of the cassava leaves. It's getting darker. And I'm going to try to clean all around the stove and the ticketu. I'll take it out to clean, and I'll clean all the other things around. Yeah, cassava leaves is nice, but very messy when it's been cooked, so we have to watch out for that. Here goes our okra. The okra gives it the slimy nature. Here goes our fish. Yes, and I give it another good stir. And there we have it. Cassava leaves is ready to eat. Yes. Give it another stir. Be careful at this point. Some of it can jump onto your hand and on your skin. I have a secret. Always keep a bottle of castor oil in your cabinet in the kitchen. Castor oil is very good to help with burns. It's soothing the area where the hot thing is, and it leaves no scar. So have a bottle of castor oil in your cabinet in kitchen. And here I'm using quinoa to eat this cassava leaves. You can use white rice or any rice of your choice. I am using quinoa. Quinoa is very easy to cook. It's just steam on a low heat. Sweet cassava leaf. Cassada leaf is sweet. Jackitunboi. Thank you. Bye.